On the 25th of April 1859, construction work began on the Suez Canal at the northern Egyptian port town of Port Said. Welcome to History Pod. The project to link the Mediterranean Sea and the Red Sea was initiated by French diplomat and engineer Ferdinand de Lesseps, who founded the Suez Canal Company with permission to construct and operate a canal for 99 years after completion. The idea to link the two seas had been considered for centuries, with Napoleon Bonaparte even investigating the feasibility of its construction during his Egyptian campaign in the late 18th century. However, early surveys incorrectly concluded that the two seas were at different elevations, so it wasn't until later improvements in engineering techniques that the project could be revisited with greater accuracy. The canal was designed as a sea-level waterway stretching approximately 120 miles across the Isthmus of Suez. Beginning on the 25th of April 1859, work initially relied heavily on manual labour. Tens of thousands of Egyptian workers were conscripted to dig the canal by hand, using only basic tools, but this system of forced labour was eventually banned under pressure from European governments. Mechanical equipment was later introduced to speed up the process. The construction faced a range of engineering, financial, and political challenges. Difficult terrain and logistical issues slowed progress, while tensions arose between the French-led company and British commercial interests. Despite this, the canal was completed in 1869, 10 years after work began. Its opening significantly reduced travel time between Europe and Asia and eliminated the need for ships to sail around the southern tip of Africa. Consequently, the Suez Canal quickly became a strategically and economically vital waterway.